Hello and welcome. My name is Manuel Quintana with Pragmatic Works, and in collaboration with MAQ Software, we're going to bring you today's video all around their custom visual known as clustering using optics. This, of course, uses the optics algorithm for density clustering, which allows us to figure out and look at outliers. Also, we don't have to define any sort of minimum number for clustering. There's some automatic parameters that are established for us, but we also have the capability of defining those parameters. So that being said, also along with downloading this custom visual from the marketplace, you will also be prompted to install some necessary requirements, some R packages that will be leveraged in creating and doing this clustering. So we've got some great functionality. This is something that's very powerful that works for us so we can get some nice clustering going on within our data. So let's head over to Power BI and explore this. So here we are in Power BI taking a look at the clustering using optics visual by MAQ Software. As we see, we also have some very simple data sets side by side here, but we're going to look at some differentiations here. There are some similarities with this as well as the visual forecast using neural network that is from MAQ Software as well, where we have these options for zooming. We can isolate certain records. We can zoom into those. Really neat, very powerful capabilities. But where the strength really lies is going to be in that optics algorithm. And the way we can choose to configure this, if we so want to, because by default, this is just taking some automatic values into consideration. But while the visual is selected, by going into the field well, we'll notice that there is a clustering settings area. As you can see, parameter settings is defined here. The only other option is going to be data scaling. This actually is going to allow you to get your access values. In case of random data, if you don't have any values, this visual will show items from -2 to -3. This is impacting the actual algorithm itself. But notice here for auto, we can switch this to user defined. Here is where we can go through the options that we can set that is leveraged within the optics algorithm. We have the Epsilon Neighbors. This actually provides the maximum distance or the potential radius that needs to be considered while making clusters. So you have to define this so you can get the entire range of distances because it'll be considered during the actual algorithm. So this is what will be controlled by the Epsilon Neighbors section. For minimum number of points in a cluster, that's pretty self-explanatory. You just have to define that number itself. And then we also have the Steepness Threshold, which is going to relate to hierarchical clustering. We can manipulate and hold these options and raise or increase them as we see fit. By going auto, these are just going to be automatically determined by the algorithm itself. So you can set and choose however you see fit. I'm going to switch this back to auto so we can see those defined clusterings. Other than cluster settings, of course, we can distinguish the background color and dictate the Y and the X axis as far as title, size, color, as you would expect. But with this, we can take advantage of that algorithm itself, that optics algorithm, to do all this clustering for us just by using those auto features. But if we want to go to the next step, if we want to go a little more advanced, as you can see, we have the capabilities of defining those parameters ourselves. So hopefully you enjoyed, and thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions about this visual or need a similar business solution, feel free to contact MAQ Software at sales@maqsoftware.com. As well, for any of your Power BI training needs, be sure to reach out to us at Pragmatic Works by emailing training@pragmaticworks.com.